Hello viewers, today we are going to see about work done by a variable force. So if you see this graph, x-axis is the distance and y-axis is the force. Now the force is varying with respect to distance. Okay, so the work done. So practically a constant force is rare. It is the variable force which is more commonly encountered. Figure 6.3 is a plot of varying force in one dimension. If the displacement del x is small, we can take the force fx as a approximately constant, and the work done is then work done is equal to force into distance, that is f of x into del x. Okay, now if you see this graph, this variable force with respect to distance we take into small rectangular segments. Now if you consider the area of this, area is equal to this distance, this small distance is del x multiplied by the force at this at that distance. So if you keep adding all those area, you will get the total work done. So this this rectangular area you first find out. For example, this is del x into this is f1, so you will get work done. So this is w1 w2 w3, so you add throughout. So this addition is we represent by summation, so that's what is told here. Adding successive rectangular areas in figure 6.3a, we get the total work done. So first work done, so we can write it as work done is approximately equal to xi to xf, this is the initial value, this is final value, f of x into del x, where the summation is from the initial position xi to the final position xf. So the idea is, for this graph, this is del x, so del x into this f1, so you will get this work done. Then you move on to the next rectangular, so that is del x into this f2, so you will get work done for this case. Then third, del x into this one, you will get a third work done. Similarly, you try to find from xi to xf, and you add all those things. So this addition is represented by summation, sigma. That's what is in this formula. So force into distance for all the right from xi to xf. If you add everything, you will get total work done. Okay. Now, if this distance del x tends to zero, that it is very close that it tends to zero, we can write the formula as, so the approximation, see actually if you take this as del x, you see some area is left over. So that means there is a error in the approximation. So if you want to have an accurate value, or if you want to move towards more accurate value, then what you have to do is, this del x, that value has to tend to zero. You must take del x, which is very very close to zero. Okay. So that means the approximation, that is each the number of areas you are going to is increased now. Okay, so very small area, so that's why del x tends to zero, that's what is written here. So work done is equal to limit del x tends to zero sigma fx to del x, lower limit is xi and upper limit is xf. And this can be said as a when del x tends to 0, we can write it in integral form, that is xi to xf is the xf is the upper limit, xi is the lower limit, integration of f of x into dx. So that means this continuously we are integrating and we are substituting the upper limit and the lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit gives the complete area under the curve. Therefore we can find the total work done. So that's what is given here. If you see, so integrating this function f of x from xi to xf, then you will get the total work done. So that's all about work done by a variable force. So in practice, we don't have a straight uniform force. In practical case, it will be a variable force. In that case, we take each, we split the entire curve into individual rectangles and then add up all those areas to get the total work done. So that's the formula here. So that's all about work done by a variable force. Hope you have understood the topic. Thanks for watching. Nandri.